Ladies and gentlemen, the Railroad Hour. And here comes our star-studded show train. Tonight, the Association of American Railroads presents a musical play by Lawrence and Lee, Penny Whistle, starring Gordon McRae and his charming guest, Lucille Norman. Our choir is under the direction of Norman Luboff, and our music is prepared and conducted by Carmen Dragon. Yes, tonight another delightful play with music is brought to you, transcribed by the American Railroads. The same railroads that bring you the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the fuel you burn, and the multitude of other things that you use in your daily life. The same railroads that bring you the finest in safe, comfortable, all-weather transportation. At low cost. And now, here is our star, Gordon McRae.
Thank you, Marvin Miller, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, Lucille Norman is Fanny Osborne Stevenson, and I am Robert Louis Stevenson, as we present Penny Whistle. Fanny, news, wonderful news.
Louis, they've accepted the poems, the Penny Whistle volume.
A whole lot of them. They promised to make a beautiful little book out of them.
Why shouldn't they? I love them. Everybody else will, too.
Oh, now, Fanny, there was nothing in the marriage vows that said you had to like everything I write.
Do you know my favorite? Bed in summer. In winter, I get up at night and dress by yellow candlelight. In summer, quite the other way. I have to go to bed by day.
Why, Fanny, you've memorized them.
How can I help it? They're all like songs. Each one sings a little melody, like songs I remember.
You spoil me. But I'm glad you like these little verses.
They mean a great deal to you, Louis, don't they?
They're memories, Fanny, of the days when I was chained to a sick bed. I couldn't run and play like the other boys, but my mind went traveling far beyond the counterpane.
How wonderful it would look in print. Penny Whistle by Robert Louis Stevenson.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. The publisher has changed the title. They're calling it A Child's Garden of Verses. Me, they'll always be my Penny Whistle. The little piping sounds I make.
If you make a little sound like a penny whistle makes. And the sound comes from your heart and soul, the world around you shakes. If you toot a tiny whistle, it'll make a little tune. And soon your penny whistle sound is floating to the moon. It travels like a thistle to India or France. Just blow your penny whistle and the world begins to dance. So fill your song with heartbeats and love and everything. And then your penny whistle will make the whole world sing. Tiny whistle, it'll make a little tune, and soon your penny whistle sound is floating to the moon.
See, Fanny, I am cursed with the disease of optimism. I write a handful of three penny verses, and already I've made myself famous.
So fill your song with heartbeats, with love and everything, and then your penny whistle.
Wait until your friend Henley hears about it.
Louie, really? How can you hope to outlast the flimsy paper of this edition by writing nursery rhymes?
Perhaps I'm not gifted with your profundity, Henley. I write what I can.
Oh, take this story. The magazine's printed it because it amuses the 12-year-olds. Treasure maps and yo-ho-ho and a bottle of rum.
I like it. I like Treasure Island.
Oh, be quiet, Fanny.
Now, Henley.
Louis, you should be wrestling with the problems of existence instead of writing, where go the boats? Dark brown is the river.
Now, wait a minute. I don't like the way you read it. Fanny, my love, say the verse the way it should be said.
Of course, Louis.
Dark brown is the river, golden is the sand. It flows along forever with trees on either hand. Green leaves are floating, castles of the foam, boats of mine are boating. When will all come home? On goes the river, and out past the mill, away down the valley, away down the hill, away down the hill. Away down the river, 100 miles or more, other little children shall bring my boats ashore.
Thank you. All right, William Ernest Henley, advocate of the deep.
There it is. Simple, unprofound, a child's song written by a child. Overgrown, perhaps, but still a child.
Oh, Louis, are you all right?
Of course, my love. I'm not dying. One of these days soon, perhaps, but not quite yet.
Oh, that's no way to speak. You must defeat death, Louis. You must be master of your universe. Here's a poem I've written. Read it. Perhaps it will strengthen you.
What a flourishing title. Invictus. Fanny, listen to Mr. Henley's formula for mastering the universe.
Out of the night that covers me, black as the pit
to bowl. I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the perplex of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody but unbound. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the years finds and shall find me unafraid.
Fine poem, Henley, a brave poem. But it's not true. God is the captain of my soul, and if God calls my ship into harbor, who am I to say the voyage must not end so soon?
Lewis, stop talking about death.
Oh, but he's going to die, Fanny. There are too many things to do, too many things to see. Fanny, let's tell Mr. Henley here how we see the world. In a nursery rhyme.
All right, Louis.
So full of a number of things, I'm sure we should all be as happy as kings.
There are stories to tell and music to sing. There are flowers to pick and birds on the wing.
A sandman to take you to lands of delight. A sunrise to starlight at night.
There are winters and autumns and summers and springs, and miles of smiles a loving heart brings. So merry, merry, loving
days. I'm sure that we are.
Penny Whistle in just a moment. Now, here is Act Two of Penny Whistle, starring Gordon McRae as Robert Louis Stevenson and Lucille Norman as Fanny Osborne Stevenson.
Robert Louis Stevenson. There.
Louis, what in the world are you writing? That looks like some kind of legal document.
It is, my love. I've just given away my birthday.
Your birthday?
Mm-hmm. I had a letter from a little girl who was born on the 25th of December.
A birthday on Christmas?
Yes, a terrible thing to happen to a child. So, listen. I, Robert Louis Stevenson, being in sound mind and pretty well, I thank you, in body, do hereby make this grant. In consideration that Miss Annie H. Idy was born, out of all reason, upon Christmas Day, I hereby transfer to her all my rights and privileges in the 13th day of November, formerly my birthday, but now completely hers, to have, hold, and enjoy by the eating birthday cake with candles and by the receiving of gifts. Miss Idy thus becomes a month and 12 days younger than she was
but will undoubtedly go on growing older from one November 13th to the next. The effect on the undersigned is more doubtful. Lacking a birthday, I may now live forever, or I might come to pieces, like the one-horse shay, at a moment's notice. Doubtless, this step is risky, but I do not the least regret that which enables me to sign myself, your delighted name, Father, Robert Louis Stevenson.
Oh, Louis, that's wonderful.
As for you and me, my love, we're going away.
Away?
I've chartered a little ship. We're going to find ourselves an enchanted isle. Tahiti or Samoa. Are you my passenger, my love? My fellow voyager?
On every sea that was ever charted.
The least the crew could do is to sing one of my songs instead of Tennyson's. Oh, well, he's the poet laureate. It sounds very singable. I wish I'd written it.
Sweet and low, sweet and low, wind of the western sea.
Said your prayers?
Like a good boy? No, but I shall. The one prayer of my life. Dear Lord, give us grace and strength. Give us courage and gaiety and the quiet mind.
Can you sleep now, my love?
I don't know. Sing to me, Fanny.
All right, Louis. There's a verse that was written long ago by a young man I once met. In fact, I liked him so much I married him.
Now, there was a foolish thing to do.
Do you remember the verse?
Oh, it's I that am the captain of a tidy little ship, of a ship that goes a-sailing on the pond. And my ship, it keeps a-turning all around and all about.
But when I'm a little older, I shall find the secret out, how to send my vessel sailing on beyond.
Then you'll see me sailing through the rushes and the reeds, and you'll hear the water singing at the prow.
For beside the dolly sailor I'm to voyage and explore,
to land upon the island where no dolly was before, and to fire the penny cannon in the bar.
I'm sure the man who named the islands of the Pacific the Happy Isles, the Enchanted Isles, had a wife as wonderful as you beside him.
Will we get there soon, Louis?
My beloved, don't you know that to travel hopefully is far better than to arrive?
Are you happy, my love? King of the island of Samoa?
Half king, half exile.
Are you sorry we came here?
I'm a failure, my love. I'm 44 and I have accomplished nothing.
Why, the men and women of this island adore you. The name they've given you is like music. Tusitala, the teller of wondrous tales.
Oh, Fanny.
And may I quote my husband? So long as we love, we serve. So long as we are loved by others, I would almost say we are indispensable.
When I wrote that, I was young and a little foolish. Life lay ahead of me. Now it is all behind me.
No, Louis. No.
Look there, out of the window. Mount Bahia with its peak floating in the clouds. That is where I wish to lie, my love. Close to the stars, but still close to the sound of the sea.
You are not going to die.
I've left a little poem. It will tell you how I feel.
Oh, my love. My love.
Could only have left behind some monument in print. Shall I be remembered for a few jingles? A handful of magazine stories that line the dustbins? My father and my grandfather built great lighthouses. Enduring lighthouses whose beacon lights cut through the dark. But my penny whistle has made such a little, little sound.
Louis! Louis! Many letters. My dear Mrs. Stevenson, may one unknown to you share your sorrow at the loss of so great a man. May I tell you only that my sick child grows better as he reads your husband's brave poems. One stanza, and the pain and loneliness seem to disappear.
I have a little shadow that goes in and out with me. And what can be the use of him is more than I can see.
Oh, Louis. Oh, my love. Dear Mrs. Stevenson, my little girl has a garden by her bedside, a garden of verses planted by your husband. My daughter is crippled, but she walks in that garden which belongs to the children of the world.
How do you like to go up in a swing? Up in the air so blue. Oh, I do think it's the pleasantest thing ever a child can do.
Oh, my love, your little penny whistle sound is floating to the moon.
So fill your song with heartbeats, with love and everything, and then your penny
well, my love, close to the stars. 10 chieftains carried you there to rest and dream. And they have carved into the mountainside the words you wrote.
This is the verse you engraved for me. Here now he lies where he longed to be.
Back in just one moment. And meanwhile, our thanks to Lou Merrill, Patty Iannone, Stuffy Singer, and our entire company. Penny Whistle, with special music by Carmen Dragon, was written by Lawrence and Lee. The music of Where Go the Boats is by Ethelbert Nevin. The Railroad Hour is brought to you each week at this same time by the American Railroads. Marvin?
23 years ago today, the world's first completely air-conditioned passenger train was placed in service. And 20 years ago, the first regular run of a diesel-electric streamline train was made. These two events foreshadowed tremendous strides that have been made by the nation's railroads to provide the finest transportation service for American travelers. For air-conditioned trains are now the rule on mainline rail routes, and powerful diesels now perform 85% of all passenger train service. Yes, these and many other improvements, all typical of modern railroading, speak for themselves in telling why so many people today prefer traveling by train.
I love that story, Gordon.
So did I, Lucy. And we want to thank a courageous and smiling school teacher, Miss Mary Eastman, who suggested that we present this musical story of Stevenson.
Thank you, Miss Eastman, from all of us.
And next week, Lucy.
I'm lonesome since I crossed the hill and o'er the moor and valley. Such heavy thoughts my heart to fill since parting with my Sally.
A musical play based on the moving and tender story of Enoch Arden. Lawrence and Lee call this new musical play Homecoming. And we're inviting Nadine Connor to play the lovely, the unforgettable Annie Lee.
Wouldn't miss it. Good night, Gordon.
Good night, Lucy. As always, you were wonderful.
Buddy Poppies are now on sale all over the nation until next Sunday. Your purchase of a Buddy Poppy will help the veterans of foreign wars continue their program of assistance to needy and disabled veterans. Buy and wear a Buddy Poppy this week.
All aboard!
Well, dear friends, it looks as though we're ready to pull out. And so until next Monday night and the premiere of our new musical play, Homecoming, on behalf of the other members of the cast and of the American Railroads, this is your friend Gordon McRae saying goodbye.
The Railroad Hour was transcribed in Hollywood. Our choir is under the direction of Norman Luboff, and our music is prepared and conducted by Carmen Dragon. This is Marvin Miller saying goodbye until next week for the American Railroads. Now, stay tuned for your Monday night of music on NBC.
Keep tuned for the Telephone Hour with Brian Sullivan on the NBC Radio Network.